main event of the evening.
Has returned to our world. To preserve it, you must be willing to fight. For Azeroth! World of Warcraft Legion.
Right, are we live? Are we live? Is anybody watching? Are we live? Okay, according to this, I have two views. Is there anybody out there in chatland that can let me know that everything's streaming as it should? It looks good from my end. But that's only from my end. I don't know what you guys are seeing right now. I'm checking my preview and everything looks hunky-dory at this present time. My I know my stream is working. It probably is working fine. I'm probably just being a bit careful. But hey ho, the stream is up. Let's announce it to the world. Let's go on Twitter and say, hey y'all. Let's just say, hey everybody, come join me. Okay. While I was just checking Twitter, a girl called Sexy Laura liked my tweets. She's not a bot or anything. No, sorry, bot. Right, okay, so I put it on Twitter, I'm putting it on Facebook. So here we go. I'm just going to make a quick video while we're here. So I am going to turn around, put on my camera, and say, hello YouTube, I'm live right now over on Twitch. That's twitch.tv/juggernaut, that's JUGANAWT. I'm going to be playing some PC Engine games tonight, ready for my big stream on Sunday, which is my birthday, and I'm going to be celebrating all the video games that came out the year I was born, 1980. It was a big year for gaming. There's a lot to cover, so that's something to look forward to. But in the meantime, we're going to continue with my top 50 PC Engine CD list by recording some more PC Engine CD games. Come and join me. It's going to be fun. Promise. Right, bye. Okay, so that's that bit done. That's that little video snippet done. Okay, so let me just get that running. So that's a 30-second clip. I'm just going to upload that while this is uploading to YouTube. My upload bandwidth is going to be a little wonky. I'm just putting in Twitch.tv/2. Come and join me on my Twitch. I'm just going to pop that right there. And I'll just put, come join me on Twitch. Twitch.tv/juggernaut. Awesome. Okay, so we're going to process that now. It should take a few seconds. And that should be published to YouTube any moment now. Hopefully some people will come on board. Let me know that the stream quality is doing all right. At the moment, I have the fan blowing behind me. I'm going to switch that off, ready for when we actually start the stream. Okay, so let's get the software set up first of all. One of the things that I needed to do was to switch controllers. So my beloved Xbox One controller suffered a bit of drift over the weekend. Over last night, really. So I'm resorting to a DualShock 4. It's not the ideal controller for PC, for me, in my opinion, but hey, gotta work with what you've gotta work with, right? So I'm gonna be using that. The fan is switched off now. So the downside with having to switch controllers is I'm gonna have to remap everything. So I'm using emulation for the PC Engine CD. So I'm just gonna go into the emulator and I'm just going to quickly run through my settings, make sure that everything is working as it should. Everything gets picked up correctly. So I'm just going to super duper quick configure my pad. So select run, button one, button two. And then we've got to configure the auto fire buttons also. So that's very easy, very simple. And we'll configure the six button pad while we're here as well. So we'll configure the six button pad. So again, very easy to do. Select run, button one, button two, button three, button four, button five, button six, right? Okay, so we will be using the two button controller for the most part. I'm gonna get the tools necessary to bring out my digital archives and put them on the stream and put them on the emulator. So that's coming up now. I'm going to switch over my footage to make sure that everything's just up and running properly. So I'm going to switch to my 4.3 and I'm going to put the PS4 controller so you can see the button presses as I press them. Look, like you can see, all of my button presses are shown on the mapping there, which is good, which is great. Let's get the screen recording footage going, which is already running, fantastic. And then let's pick our first game, shall we? What are we going to pick? What are we going to go with? What are we going to do? What are we going to start with? So I've got 108 games to go through. I'm not going to play them all today. I've been playing them over a period of the last couple of weeks. What am I going to do today? Let's try... You know what? I've got an idea. I can't decide, so I'm going to get the machine to decide for me. I'm going to bring in my randomized picker from my random select videos. I'm going to point it towards my directory where I have my PC Engine CD games. I'm going to let the computer do the decision for me. Whether it will work, I don't know. Because these are directories instead of actual files. It should, in theory, work, but you can never tell for sure until we actually get it done. So I'm going to navigate over to my PC Engine / TurboGrafx-16 CD folder, and I'm just going to do a test run, see what happens. It's thinking about things. Is it gonna work? No. Okay, so never mind that then. I have to do it the old-fashioned way. So I am gonna pick the game that sounds the dodgiest, and that's Virgin Dream. So the first game we play today will be Virgin Dream. I wonder what that dream could be, and I wonder if it's gonna be a soggy game, a wet game. Okay. Here we go. Now, you should see the game footage as we speak. Everything cool? Everything great? Awesome. Right, it's beer time. Cheers, everyone. Right, let's get this rolling. Tokuma Shoten Intermedia Incorporated. Virgin Dream! So what am I, managing a beauty contest of some description? Her eyes cover up a third of her face. I have no idea what she's saying right now. She's asking me my name, perhaps? So, let's see. So let's put my name as... Yeah, so I was born in 1980, September 25th. My blood type is O for, oh yeah. Okay, that's right. I have no idea what this menu says. I was told that this game was playable without any Japanese knowledge whatsoever. So, I was told wrong. Okay, this already has dodgy connotations with it. Why is her ass poking out so far?
こんにちは。こんにちは。こんにちは。こんにちは。私は獅子戸玉九州代表よ。よろしくね。うん。あとこちらは北海道代表の河野池さんと。Agreed。河野池さんよりです。よろしくね。こちらこそよろしくお願いします。うん。
私は真鍋恵子。よろしくね。全く本当。ごめんなさい。Yeah, I'm sorry too. Why do all of her faces look like they're sticking their tongue out randomly? Like, there are the worst portraits I've ever seen.
Shishido Tamae, 17歳, Kyushu Chiku Daihyo. Atosakio Kangaizuni Hashiridashite Shimau Keikou ga
aru. Those sandals do not match that skirt in that top.
Daro. Konoike Sayu. Manabe Keikou, 18歳, Tohoku Chiku Daihyo. Yokozuki de Achikochi wo Tabishite Mawatte iru toyu Ottori shita Nichijou kara wa Souzou dekinai Shumi ga aru.
Yeah, what he said.
なんか今好き勝手なこと言われてた気がするわね。え?空耳じゃないの?確かに聞こえたと思ったのに。気にしない、気にしない。
I would love to know what they say. Let's skip it.
申し遅れました。
Let's skip the weird looking doll and the camel toe lady. Let's go straight to the game. Oi oi. Oi oi. Indeed. Wow, my PC's getting hot. This was blocking the vent. Oops. Great book, by the way. The US Gold story. Very good book. Wow, my PC is toasty. I think the person that told me that this was playable was full of shit. Come on, how much story is there? Right, enough of that, screw that. Virgin Dream is a non-starter. It's obviously not playable in English, so it won't be valid for my list. Let's get rid and move on to the next one. So, this I know is playable in English. It's also a really good game. Because it's Super Raiden. Yeah. Okay, let's go. That's the demo, not me. I accidentally set my bomb off. This is great conversion. They've done a good job of compressing it down to a 4x3 screen. Normally these shmups are on a vertical resolution. They've done a great job in localizing it for the PC Engine CD. Soundtrack's great. Graphics are nice. Feels good, handles well. Although I do find the DualShock 4 a little bit spongy for games like this. Yeah, a little bit spongy. But workable. Woo! Boom, shucky lucky. Man, this D-pad feels weird after being used to the Xbox Ones for so long. It's real spongy. I'm gonna take some practice with it. But the actual game itself, nah, I'm enjoying this already. Gonna miss me. Oh shit. Hang on, my phone's ringing. I don't know where my phone is. Where is my phone? Where is my phone? I don't know where my phone is. It's ringing from somewhere. Oh, it's on the floor. For some reason, I had an alarm set at midnight. What the hell? Okay, that must have been my children set that up. They have a habit of doing stuff like that sometimes. My kids love technology almost as much as their old man does. My one-year-old already likes to fight for the phone. Man, I'm gonna die, look. That threw me off totally. So it's due overtime. Let's use a credit and let's start again. Here we go. No easy mistakes this time. We don't like the easy mistake to make us. Oh, one's down already. Look at that. Much easier the second time round. Let's move on. Stage one clear. awful score, but it's clear. That's all that matters. Okay, so we'll do the second stage, and we'll record footage of that. Oh, crap, what happened there? It reset the game. Okay, I think there's something to do with this DualShock 4 controller that's kind of throwing controls out for everything else. I'm just going to check the profile, making sure that the touchpad isn't used for anything, because it can be quite temperamental, to say the least. No, but everything's fine. Okay, well, we'll call it there for Super Raiden. We've got enough footage to work with anyway. So let's get rid of Super Raiden. Let's move on to the next game. So we've got a lot of shmups left to do. We have things like Vestil 1 and 2. We've got Monster Lair, Gate of Thunder, Fossa Amor, Hellfire S, Image Fight. But let's go with another Japanese name that I'm not familiar with gameplay-wise. This one is called Ryoku no Ken. So Ken is fist, I know that much. I don't know what the Ryoku bit is. We are going to find out soon enough, though. Oh, and it's a six-button game. Cool. Let's check it out. Oh, it's Art of Fighting. Okay. I know what Art of Fighting is. Yeah. That's right. Let's roll. So let's go, I'm going to have to reconfigure my controls, because this is going mental. Okay, so up, right, down, left, select, run, button 1, button 2, button 3, button 4, button 5, button 6. Okay, that's more like it. There we go. So am I going to play as Ryo or Robert? I'm going to go as Ryo. Whatever he said. Let's do this thing. When you're quite ready. Here we go.
One, fight.
So the first thing I notice is the scaling is present and correct. It may not be the smoothest scaling ever known to man, and you've got this hideous black box or black borders surrounding the characters when you do zoom out, but it's there, man. Which can't be said for a lot of the conversions. And I am getting my ass looked. Dah. Okay.
Round two, fight.
Let's try and get the punch in. No, that's taunt. I don't know any of the moves for this game. Oh, there we go. It's kind of a reverse Tatsumaki Senpu Kyoku move. You have to press back, then down back, and then through to forward, which is kind of interesting. And why does he look like he's blowing out birthday candles? Oh, that works a treat. Look at that. So how do I do my fireball? I know Ryo's got a fireball, but I can't remember how it's done. And while I'm fumbling for the controls, I'm getting my ass whooped. Oh. It's neck and neck, but I break his first. Blowing out that birthday cake again, look at that. Oh, and he's not a pretty sight.
Yuri.
Here we go. Brawl at the bar.
Round one, fight.
Feet of Doom. Wow. Holy crap, my life bar is sinking fast. And do you see that? We actually get visual damage representation on our characters. I've got a bruise on my face. That's pretty cool. In fact, that's really cool. You don't see that very often. In fact, I can't think of another game where that happens. Except for Mortal Kombat. No, son of a bitch.
Get out of my way, kid.
Get out of my way, kid.
Round
He's come
two.
From the Street Fighter School of Voice Acting. Son of a bitch! Hot damn!
Get out of my way, kid.
Get out of my way, kid. Okay, that's enough art of fighting for one day. I was never a huge, huge fan. So, Ryoku no Ken is art of fighting. Good to know, good to know, good to know. Okay. Right, so what is going to be next? What is going to be next? Let's go for a golf game. Hugh, PGA, power tour... I'm all tongue-tied. Lame. Let's start that again. Hugh, PGA Tour, Power Golf 2. Golfer. What a great subtitle. Just golfer. Okay. And it's a mouse-orientated game. Wow. Okay, there aren't that many mouse-based games for the PC Engine CD, so this is in limited company. And video footage. This is interesting. Hmm. Kind of neat presentation when you consider the age and the era that this was released in. Technically impressive. I would say that that actually has more colors than the Sega CD does. I mean, okay, it's running in a smaller frame, but, you know, that's pretty good, that's pretty good. So let's hope the game holds out, huh? Because that is a really good first impression. So, let me turn my sensitivity down on my mouse to make sure I can actually use it. So where am I going to go, first of all? Well, let's go for the first option and click OK. So first I'm going to select one player, put my name in, if it'll let me, come on. Right. Okay. Again, really, really good presentation on this. I'm quite impressed. And let's see what the basic screen layout's like. Here's where it gets a little flakier. Yeah. Okay, so what's the wind like? Okay, so I'm going to adjust slightly for wind. I'm going to land my shot about there, I think. Now, the proof in these games is always in how the swing mechanics work. Yeah, so I'm going to go about there. Okay, so I've selected my shot. What do I do now? I want to get 256 if I can. So I take my shot. Pow, pow. Okay, so you got a three-click mechanism. You check your power, and then your height, and then your horizontal angle on the ball. Alright, so it's pretty straightforward. Should get this down quite quickly. The screen draws a little slow, but certainly not too bad. So I want to go about 187 distance on there. I love the audio track with wildlife on it. That's really nice. Okay, so what is the maximum 200 yard? Okay, so I've basically got to pelt it with this three iron. So let's take my shot. That's pretty much dead center. That's a good shot. The wind is going to take it off slightly. I'm just going to land shy of the green. Am I actually on the green or am I on the rough? No, I'm on the green. Neat. Okay. That worked out quite nicely. No, don't you dare roll off the other side, you son of a bitch. Okay, that rolled way too far. So I've got a pitching wedge. I'm right on the edge of the green. 13 yards. I'm on a sand wedge. Okay, so I gotta make this a very low shot. That should do it. Okay. Roll me on a bit closer to the hole would be nice, but that'll do. And we're on for par. So the putter gives me 160 feet. I've got 9 feet. Again, it's going to have to be a very low shot. That should just about do it. Dead center if possible. There we go, nice par. Okay, so it's the controls are quite manageable. The game is quite responsive in that regard. So let's view a replay. Replay. No fancy TV angles there. Just a replay of what I already just saw. Still, pretty neat. No more replays. So here we are. Hole number two. We've got wind 9 meters to the right. It's quite a short course. So how far can my driver take me? 270. Okay, so let's aim to a little bit to the left. Before we take our shot this time, I'm going to see what the TV angles we have are. I can set TV angles, camera angles, for the shot. How awesome is that? Okay, cool. So does that mean when I take my shot, it's going to give me a TV style view between them all? If that's the case, then that's freaking awesome, really? For the age of this game, that is really cool. What are my other options like? So I can see my foliage around the area. I can change my stance. I don't know what the thumbs down is. Perhaps that's mulligan or something. My tee, I can change the layer, see the layer of the land. But we don't need to worry about any of that. The wind is going down towards us. We are going to whack this ball as hard as we can. Oh, I'm slightly off kilter. That is going to drift to the right and not go very far at all. But look at that. That's really cool, the way it changes the TV angles to where I set the cameras. That is super cool. What a great feature. Wow, I am really, really impressed with that. Really impressed. So let's do that again. Let's have, well, no, actually, we already set the angles, didn't we? So 3IN can take me 200 yards. I've got 188. I need to land it about there. Oh, I've chipped it a little bit. Oh, that's not a great shot. The wind is going to take that well away from where I want it to be. In the bunker? Which bunker? Which ones are going to? That bunker, right next to the green. Okay. It could be worse, could be worse. 79 yards to go. We got 100 yards on this sandwich. Let's give it a good whack. Oh, put a bit of forward spin on that. It's not going to go too far. Yeah, that's a disappointment. So I'm going to try that again. This time hit the ball a little lower, and that should take me right to the pin. All over the pin and over the green like a dumbass. Don't take me off the green. Don't take me off the green. Okay. This is a long, long putt. At a slight angle, downhill. Okay, so I need to aim slightly off. Same about there. What do you reckon? Let's check the lay of land again. Actually, that looks fairly straight, so I'm going to readjust. I'm going to go directly at the hole. That may be a bit too much power for downhill. And it's off. So that means I'm firing it uphill for the next shot. This is double, triple bogey territory for sure. My ball is still rolling. I may be even out of the green at this point. Okay. Let's just twat it. Twat it! Oh, well overshot. Oof. But that is a really cool game. Hugh PGA Tour Power Golf 2 has impressed me. It really has. I think that's enough of that, though, before we all fall asleep. Golf isn't exactly the most exciting game to view. So let's get rich, shall we? It'd be nice if I could get my mouse back. No, I don't want to save my state. No. I just want to unmount the disc. Audio has crashed. And we're back. So my PC didn't like that too much, and it crashed my Adobe Audition, which I used to live edit my vocals to get rid of any background noise I may have. And it completely crashed it out. So I apologize for that. My vocals went dead for a moment, but we are back. We are live. We are rolling, and we are rolling on to the next game, which will be... this sounds interesting. Kazekiri Ninja Action. Let's hit it. Is it gonna work? Is it gonna work? Load error. I want Kazekiri Ninja Action, not load error. Work, please. There we go, Kazekiri. Let's see what this game's like. Oh, it's Naxatsoft. That's always a fairly good sign. Naxatsoft made some really, really good PC Engine games. Let's hope this is one of them. Japanese rooftop. More Japanese rooftop. Cage. Anime style lady. Observational commentary. Evil look. Haven't got a clue what's going on. Uh-oh. Clash of clans. Bit of gore. And the area littered with corpses. Scared anime lady who looks about 12. Anime boy who looks about 12. Full moon rising. Don't the bad guys ever attack apart from on a full moon? Determined face. With a plaster on it, like Nelly. Two frames of animation. And here we go. The animation is pretty neat on this. Very smooth looking animation. And if you hold up and use diagonals, you can run faster as well. So it's a platformer slow stroke brawler, and it looks like all I've got to do is eliminate a certain amount of enemies before I can move on. Yes, okay. Here comes the tunes. Wah, surprise! How'd you like my sword to your feet? Wah! You wish you just took my throwing stars to the face instead. Wow, he almost runs at subhuman speed. Hi, Nintendo. Yeah, you're right. There doesn't seem to be an awful lot of platforming. Maybe my first impression was slightly wrong. It seems to be just basically clear a wave of enemies, move on to the next screen. But it's quite neatly presented. Oh, we have a slide. I wonder what other moves we have. Yeah, we have a downward slide as well. Now that's a very neat feature. I don't know if you can see that on stream, but the shadow of the tree actually is reflected on the sprite. They put a shadowy background layer where the shadow of the tree would be. That is a really nice touch and a very subtle one. The amount of programming it would have taken to do that for the relatively subtle effect is commendable. Yeah, really impressed. Naxat software were very good at doing these little tweaks and these little features that you wouldn't notice at first glance. Okay, the foreground is severely obstructing my view. Not that it matters a great deal at the moment, but it may do. Let's just keep running. We've killed all the enemies it says we need to kill. So let's go on to the boss. Let's see what the bosses are like. You know what? Now that I'm starting to play this and looking at the background, this is, you're right, it's basically Kung Fu Master, yeah? Yeah, the staircase, the bosses, the maneuvering from enemy to enemy, yeah, it is exactly like Kung Fu Master. Also known as Spartan X, of course, in Japan. So it's a flashier Kung Fu. I can get with that. Man, the boss makes light work of me. And he's seemingly immune to slides. So it's just the old fashioned sword then. Woo! And the body slams. No, don't you body slam me. I want to body slam you. And there we go. Make him miss, run in and throw. That seems like a good strat. Yep, that's how we do. Okay. I wonder how far I can run without actually killing everyone. Ow. About that far. Okay, I'm at the end of the level. Will they all come running at me, or do I have to scale back and go to them? Looks like I have to go back to them. Okay. A bit annoying, but never mind. I was trying to break the game in a way. I wasn't playing as the game intended to. Would have been nice if they'd have thought of that with their programming, but it is what it is. Come here. Ah. Okay guys, so how's the stream looking? When I checked the stream, it looked fairly stable, but any input that you guys have on that will be of great help for me. because of course I can only see it while streaming. I can't see what it's actually like for you guys to view. So if you could let me know in the chat, that would be fantastic. That way, if I need to tweak anything, I can do. Whether audio levels, whether it's visuals, whether it's buffering, if there's something that needs fixing, let me know. In fact, I'm going to turn down the game audio level a touch. There we go. While I hack my way through these bad guys. Ooh. Yeah, this isn't bad. It's very simplistic, but it's not bad. Last two enemies I need to kill. Why won't you die? Come on, you make it easier for everyone. Just kill over. There we go. Finally, somebody that stands to reason. Let's get to the end. Boss time. Oh, he looks like me. Except with a sweatband and longer hair. And a shitty green outfit. Come on. Invincibility frames stink. Blocking everything. So I take it you don't have to kill him. I guess you just have to fight to a stalemate then. Let's go snorkeling. Woo. Climbing and a bit of rope swinging. Starting to feel the repetition of this game. It's very samey. There doesn't seem to be a great variety in enemies. Or basically different combinations you have to learn to defeat them. You can essentially just defeat them by swinging your sword till they fall over. A little bit more thought could have gone into that. Ah, son of a bitch. I get the feeling this is a game that could be speedrun. Could be speedrun quite quickly with a bit of practice. There is definitely techniques available. There are definitely techniques available that could allow you to blast through this game really, really quickly. Shuriken. I'm struggling to get the slide going to the left as well. It's probably just me. All of the enemies I need to get to the next area. Boss time. And it's a female assailant. Throw her by the hair. You leave your monkeys out of this. Trying to string combos together, it's just not working. You just have to wait for predetermined times to actually hit her by the look of things. Ow! Just frickin' die! Thank you. So glad you listened. Okay, so that's not bad. I quite enjoyed that. It is a little repetitious, but Kazei Kiri Ninja Action gets a pass from me. Will it be on my top 50 list? Yeah, I couldn't tell you at this point. I don't know. I'll have to think about it. But yeah, my experience was enjoyable, if a little repetitive. So let's move on to the next game. Now, I could have sworn I've played this before. It's a game called Moonlight Lady. I'm sure I've played it. Almost 100% certain I've played it before. But I can't remember anything about it, so let's play it. Okay, so this is Moonlight Lady. Let's get it recording, ready for the footage. level 1. Long. We'll skip the cutscene. This is an RPG. Whoever told me that this was playable in English is full of shit. Okay, that is not a playable game in English. You can tell already what kind of game it's going to be. It is going to be a Japanese RPG style game that is going to be pretty much unplayable for anybody who doesn't understand Japanese, such as myself. Can we take a shit on the toilet? We gotta answer the serious questions here on the Juggernaut Show. Can you take a shit on a video game toilet? No, you can't even open the door. No wonder why she looks so upset. She's gonna go to her computer and look at porn instead. Oh, what's this? An orb. Oh, it's touching me in my love place. It's speaking to me. Gomenasai, it's saying sorry. Sorry for making your dear for JJ glow like sparkles. Yeah. Okay. Let's skip this. Let's see if there is a game in here somewhere that is a remotely playable for English speakers. Only the ones that don't speak Japanese can't read a word of it. I've got a bird now? What the fuck? Skip, 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 skip. For those of you who read and understand Japanese, I apologize. I'm probably ruining a perfectly good story. Probably really entertaining, but for me, I haven't got a freaking clue what's going on. All I know is that he looks like he's got a penis on his head. What the hell? What the hell is that? Okay, that's just freaking creepy. I haven't got a clue what it says, but the moment I turn away, it turns into an evil penis. I don't know who she is, what I'm supposed to do, but evil penis creature scares the living bejesus out of me. Let's get the hell out of here. Yeah. Let's go. And lo and behold, we are in full RPG mode. Yeah, there is nothing of any redeeming quality here for me. RPGs, you absolutely need to know the language for. If you don't know the language, there is no point in playing it. So, it is with regret, especially when it comes to TurboGrafx CD games, PC Engine CD games. There are probably a multitude of great titles that I'm missing out on purely because I don't understand Japanese, but let's face it, not many of us outside of Japan do know Japanese, so in my lists, I have to consider that you've got to enjoy it while knowing the basic language of English. If you can't play a game regardless of its language or anything like that, then I can't really add it into my list. Let's see if wrestling is any easier. Should we try this Wrestling Angels? Let's give Wrestling Angels a go. Okay. Wrestling Angels, here we go. It's a game made by NEC themselves. and it's got the traditional pink-haired anime lady. I think it's a requirement in games of the 90s. You must have at least one pink-haired anime-style character. Let's skip the story because we aren't going to be able to understand it. But we do understand boobies. Let's play an exhibition. I'm going to stick it at level 1. How do we choose our character? There we go. Right. Okay, so we have this range of characters to choose from. Quite a few wrestlers by the look of things. Of course, it makes absolutely no difference. I'm going to go with the one that looks like a smiley face in the USA, purely because I can recognize that a bit better. And who is her opponent going to be? Wow, is she actually wearing anything? She looks like she's far too overdressed to be in a wrestling ring. Is there anyone actually normal here? Wow, look at the chin on that. Hello, I'm Mrs. Chin. There is a wide variety of wrestlers here. A wide, wide variety. Wow, I'm not even halfway through the list. Okay, there is obviously nobody normal in the entire catalogue, so I'm just going to pick Weird Tri-Spiked Face Lady. And I'm assuming that's go. Okay, so here we are. Fight. Oh. I see. And it's not even remotely over-sexualized, not at all. Let's go DDT. Which one's which? Because the characters in the animations look absolutely nothing like the character on my screen. Okay, so I'm the one in the red top on the center screen. Right, gotcha. Boom shaki laki. Choking me out. Okay, again, this is another game where you absolutely probably need Japanese, or at least you need to play this for a long amount of time so that you can understand what each of these moves are. It seems to be card oriented. But I haven't got a clue what's going on. I don't know how to win. I don't know how to defend. Now that is a non-starter for me. I just don't understand it, so I can't realistically put it in my list of top 50 games when I can't understand how to play it or enjoy playing it. So away it goes. Let's get something I can enjoy. It's about time we busted out I know we did the sequel, but we haven't done the original yet. It's crazy in a good way. It's awesome in a good way. I think it will probably will be on my top 50 list at some point and some place. It is Chou Aniki. We played I Chou Aniki. This is Chou Aniki. Trust me, even in English, this game would not make any sense. So let's skip the story. Let's go normal. Now we can pick a god or a goddess. Let's go for a god. Now just be warned, this game gets a little cray cray. It starts off sane enough, but it, trust me. Now I have a wrestler on the hunt for protein helping me. Sorry, they're not wrestlers, are they? They are, they're bodybuilding brothers, apparently. And they're not gay, they just like muscles. According to the official lore, anyway. But personally, I think they're as gay as the flowers. And that's no bad thing, you know? I can embrace multiculturalism. I'm a big supporter of LGBT. And it's great to know that a game released in 1992 kind of embraced those ideals. And also made a kick-ass game out of it. Just die already. I hate being trapped at the top of the screen. Whoa. How much more are you gonna take? I'm feeling under pressure here. Really under pressure. I know I'm gonna make a mistake any minute now. Oh no, I made it! Hooray! Okay, this defies explanation right now. I haven't got a clue what's going on. We've got tumbling guys, we've got bombs going left, right, and center. We've got what looks like Ihachi Mishima statues and awards floating at me. Yeah. What can you say? Apart from WTF. There's my proteiner. Oh yeah, my muscle man. Muscle man v Birdman, huh?
Beard up.
Beard up, did he just say? Did he just say beard up? Wow. Down you go. Yeah, Nintendo, there are quite a few games that are playable with limited knowledge of Japanese on the PC Engine CD. I had a list of about 140 games. We've gone through maybe 30 of those. And out of those, most have been playable to some degree. Or to most degrees, really. Okay, you might miss out on story. Like, for example, this game. But as I said, this game's so fucking crazy that even if it was in English, I don't think I'd understand the story. But most games are playable. It's just the ones that are disguised as action games, but in actual fact are RPGs, or those strategy-based sports games like that wrestling game we just saw. Those are the ones we can't really play, unfortunately. But there is still a wealth in the library of the PC Engine CD that is playable for non-speakers of Japanese, and that's part of why I'm doing this video, really, so that everybody can expand their horizons a little bit and enjoy some games that they may never have seen before, along with some favorites that they have. Okay, here we go.
Wow,
that is a big sprite for a PC Engine. Off you go, matey. I ain't afraid of no ghost. Yeah, there we go. So that's level one. And it just gets more and more mental from this point onwards. Now I'm fighting chess pieces. Chess pieces that spit out chess pieces. Knights and pawns. Damn, died. Look at these muscle portraits. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is exactly the same game as Gainug. If it is, they certainly had some sprites changed around. Because I sure as hell don't remember any muscle men with protein in Gainug. Thanks, Nintendo. Support is always welcome. I always like to hear that people enjoy what I put out. Ooh. The game's crashed. There we go. Yeah, so a little while ago I thought, well, I better record another list. It's been a while since I've done one. And then it dawned on me, well, why wait to release a video about the lists when I can make a stream about making the list and just share it with people? And that way, any games I may have missed can be recommended by the people watching. We can talk about the games as and when I'm playing them, get initial reactions, whatnot, if for games I've never played before. So I thought, yeah, I'll start live streaming. So I've been live streaming for a little while, once in a blue moon, mostly on YouTube, because Twitch doesn't always work for me. But now it seems like Twitch is working with OBS properly, so I'm going to be probably migrating all my streams over to Twitch, and then archiving them on YouTube later. And then when we've recorded footage for each one of these games, we're going to do all 108 remaining for the PC Engine CD. When I've recorded and played each and every one of those, I'll go away, I'll start compiling a list, putting them in order of preferences, re-reviewing the footage I've made, and start compiling a video of my favorites. And we might do a compilation of the worst games as well, because there is a astonishing amount of shittiness available on PC Engine CD for a multitude of different reasons as well. Some games are shitty because they're FMV based, some are shitty just because they look dreadful and they play awful. Some are shitty because they're called Camp California. Yeah, I think Gainug is a different game. It may be made by the same publisher. I'm not entirely certain, but the Chou and Aniki series, they're something that has to be experienced. They really are. There is a massive catalogue of Chou and Aniki games. At this point, there is at least six games in the series. And they're all batshit crazy. But that's enough recording-wise for this game. It's time to move on to the next one. Odameda, indeed. Right, so that's enough footage for Chou and Aniki. Time to move on. So I've got a lot of shooter maps. The thing with the PC Engine CD is there is a awful amount of shooters available. I mean, it really is shooter heavy. If you're a shmup fan, then the PC Engine CD will be paradise for you. I'm just looking. We have 100 games left to go, and I can see at least 30 of those are going to be shmups. Now, I don't mind a good shmup, and I will be starting the next shmup in a moment. I'm just going to go to the bathroom, so I'm going to take a quick break. I'm going to flick my channel over to my loading screen, and I'll be right back. When we return, we are going to be playing PC Dengin Rockabilly Tengoku, also known as Air Zonk 2. So I'm getting that ready to rock. Okay, it's all set up and ready to go. So I will be right back. I'm just going to the bathroom. That's what beer does to you, I'm afraid. It makes you want to go to the loo quite often. So I will return very shortly. Just give me a couple of minutes and I'll be right here ready to play. Okay, people, I am back. I'm feeling a bit better and a bit more refreshed. So where were we? Air Zonk 2, wasn't it? Yep, so we're going to move on to Air Zonk 2, also known as CD Denjin Rockabilly Tengoku. That is the next game on the list, and that is what's loading right now. For some reason my audio isn't working. I'm hoping that that's just on my side and not on the actual stream. There we go, good, right. Okay, Rockabilly Paradise. That's it, CD Denjin. You twat that guy in the toe. That's not annoying in the slightest. Let's just take a moment to appreciate the amount that this annoys. Who in their right mind thought that this was a good idea? Who's responsible for this? Who is responsible for this? Why would you put this on your title screen? Hold on. I'm going to turn my mic off so you can appreciate this in its entire glory. Okay, so let's get back to the title screen so that you can enjoy. Off yet? That is ridiculous. Okay, let's get into the game. Stage select. Okay, so we'll go to the far left to begin with. The C stage. I love cute 'em ups, don't you? Shoot 'em ups are great, but cute 'em ups are greater. Meh. Especially crazy ones like this. No, there's already too much going on. I'm juggling enemies, I'm shooting what appears to be a mixture of rice and bats and helicopters and clouds that look like drunk octopi. What the heck? And the enemies react only to my movements. Whoa. You gotta love it. A game that doesn't take itself seriously, has a sense of humor, and is really enjoyable. What the hell is this? I'm firing sushi. I am flinging sushi like a master chef that can breathe underwater with his mouth open. What am I supposed to do with this block? Am I unlocking a secret? Is it a bug? What am I doing? It doesn't seem to do anything. Okay? Right. Let's just carry on spreading that sushi love. Now, the story of Erzong was that he is a distant relative of PC Genjin, Pycanthropus Computerus, also known as Bonk. So Zonk is the future great 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 grandchild of Bonk. And you can certainly see the similarities between the two games. I'm gonna die. I chose Borley. And now I'm shrunk. I'm no bigger than the sushi I'm flinging. Boss time. The boss is really trying to screw me. Bet he's a ray of sunshine. Whoa! I didn't realize the mines were coming out of his head. I didn't see that until it was too late. What the hell is that? Whatever it is, I've given him the boot. I have no idea what that said. But yada! I did it. Bye-bye, says the fish, go to next. Okay. I'd love to go to next. How do I go to next? Do I just wait for the game to load? What's going on? I want to go to next. That's what it's telling me. Come on. Oh dear. Perhaps that fish saying bye-bye was a prophecy. Saying, I've had enough of you. I'm not letting you play my game no more. Okay, well, we did get some footage recorded. Only a very limited slice, but it's enough to work with. It's a great game. I have played that quite a bit before, so I am already confident that that is going to make the top 50 list. Along with the following game, which is definitely, absolutely going to be in the upper end of the top 50 list. This game has already been featured on some other of my videos, my top 50s. Cotton's great. No matter what system you play it on, Cotton's wonderful. I love it as a shoot 'em up series. It's basically about a hungry little witch who likes to eat candy. Also known as Willows. Oh look, you can see the story. It's actually in English. Hooray. Okay, so we'll let the story run. I love the graphical style, the art direction. And do you notice the icon to the left of the main screen changes depending on who's speaking? whether it's a narrator, whether it's a Willow, whether it's Cotton. Cotton doesn't give a shit about the world. All she cares about is feeding her face. Let's go! And without further ado, we're right into an action-packed adventure. Now these gems, depending on what color you use, they can change your enhancements. The kind of orangey color gems gain you experience, which in turn make your weapons stronger and faster. You can also get points for the yellow ones. And I've forgotten what the other colors are. It has been a while since I played it, a couple of years. But basically, I like to build up experience. It helps you through later levels. The blue, I think, yeah, the blue gives you magic potions, as does the red. Different colors give you different magic. If I remember rightly, the red was the most useful. The bigger the gem is, of course, the more experience you gain. Very simple, very straightforward stuff, but it's a wonderful title. It's got a real sense of personality in it. It's got a real challenge later on as well. I just think the Cotton series is great. With the exception of Rainbow Cotton, was it Rainbow Cotton? The Dreamcast one. Was it Cotton? Yeah, Rainbow Cotton, I think it was called. That one was a bit lackluster. It was the follow-up for the Sega Mega Drive Panorama Cotton. And it just didn't quite work. It didn't have any of the charm. Bollocks! I'm too focused on what I'm gonna say, and I keep making silly mistakes, so I am gonna be a little quieter, and I'm gonna try and work my way a bit further through this game. He says, dying frickin' immediately like an asshole. Okay, alright, let's carry on. It's a dreidel with a face on it. But those special effects, you know, of wobbling backgrounds, that would take quite some doing back in the day. You know, that was quite an advanced programming technique. Damn it. Try again. Nice and easy this time. Let's not... I was just about to say, let's not make any mistakes. But when you've got a limited playfield and a large sprite in a shmup, you are inevitably gonna get hurt at some point. My entire character is the hitbox. There's no specific area of the character that I have to make sure doesn't hit a bullet. It's my entire character that I have to make sure misses bullets. Which is an extra challenge compared to most games, or most recent shmup games, anyway. Hot damn. If I keep sucking, I'm gonna have to turn in my gamer card. And now I'm using a PlayStation 4 controller, but even still, come on, I gotta do better. Okay, I'm starting to level up. should make the onslaught a bit more tolerable. Yeah. Okay, back to the boss. I'm gonna just start firing magic. Pretty much straight away. I don't wanna last on this boss longer than I have to. There we go. It's tea time, let's pick up the tea. As much as we can get. Okay, that's not a bad haul. Could have been better. Level 2. Hehehe, XD. Tyler 1, yeah. I love this picture. Such personality in this game. Okay. Let's just keep plugging on. Okay, evil tree coming to life. Ow. Destroying me with little trees. It's another shinobi! What the fuck? Oh, you are kidding me. You are kidding me. Okay, well, it looks like my DualShock 4 controller has decided that we'd had enough playing Cotton, even though I was enjoying myself and I love that game, and it's easily going to be in my top 50. PlayStation controller said, no, screw you guys, you press this button, I'm going to reset the PC engine for you. How you like me now? Shit. Okay. Oh well, we do have to get through 98 more games, so I guess prompting us to move on to the next one's no bad thing. Let's do a football game. Or soccer, depending on where you are in the world. There's been quite a focus on football lately on my channel. I've had not one but two videos covering football, thanks to Random Select. I had Alexi Lalas International Soccer and FIFA 06 recently on the channel. And right now we're going to have Formation Soccer 95 Della Serie A. And it's an arcade card game, so it needs extra memory to run. And it's just loading that data in now. Italia. Excuse me while I have one of these biscuit things. They're really good, actually. They're really tasty. But you know what's tastier, actually? Now, screw that. I just remembered what I have here.
Cookie.
Here we go. Let us begin. So who are we going to play as? Should we play as Juventus? Yeah, let's go as we're in Juventus. Okay, that guy looks like Mr. Resetti off Animal Crossing. Who are we up against? Okay, it seems the game's up until this point. So, here we go. We're against Brescia. We're gonna have standard 4-4-2 formation. In a 19,000 crowd capacity stadium. Studio Mario Rigamonti, wherever that is. Okay, this is going to be arcadey football, isn't it? Yes, it is. Although I fouled somebody in the first 5 seconds with a yellow. Okay, wow, that is not a good start. Oh, it's quick. Oh, I wasn't quite expecting that. Oh, it's very, very fast pace. Oh, and they've scored already! Crikey. Ow. They've scored again, what bastards. Give me a chance, guys, come on. Okay, so unlike most arcadey football games, when you pass on this, it doesn't pass directly to the player on your team. It passes in a general direction, which is great for setting up moves, but crap for people like me who have just played the game for the first time and haven't got a clue of what to expect. Hence why I'm 2-0 down and we've got like less than 5 minutes into the game. Ugh. And they're quick pacey on the ball. Yeah, the ball does not glue to you whatsoever. You are in full control of where that ball lands. It doesn't matter where your defenders are, where your attackers are, where your position is on the field. Wherever you pass that ball is where it's going to go. Some people may really love that. I would prefer the more easier accessibility option of it going to the feet of my player. Because I am getting my ass handed to me already. It's 3-0. We're in the first half. I've barely had any possession whatsoever. I can't even pass the ball on the kickoff without getting into trouble. That's a foul. Come on, man. Okay, we're beating out all the defenders. He shoots and it's skied. Ugh. Oh, what a tackle. No, give me my ball back, you bastard. No bicycle kick for you, pal. No. Screw you. What the Wow, he booted it out of my goalie's hands. This is harsh. What a brutal game of football. It takes no prisoners whatsoever. It will beat you into submission and smile as it does it. In the first half. Wow. They just snatched that ball right from under you. Can't even catch up, look. I try and pass my ball towards my teammates and it just, nothing happens. Okay, here we go. No. My first attempt on target, the first time I got into the goalie's box, and the whistle just blows. And that's not the only thing that blows, my skill at this game blows as well. I am dreadful at this. It's not quite arcadey, it's not quite simmy, it's somewhere in the middle. And I'm not quite sure what to make of it, to be honest. It's sure as hell better than that trio of sports games that was on that we did on stream the other day. But this is relentless. I am getting brutalized. Come on, let me dodge. No. Come on, spread out, lads. No, and it's skied again. It's very hard to get a shot on goal. It's very hard to keep the ball. Come on, foul ref, foul. No. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. It's just the players on the enemy team are doing perfect passes. They're stealing the ball at every opportunity. And I'm getting frustrated. Really frustrated, actually. Fuck this game. Quite simply, fuck this game. You can't keep the ball. No matter how hard I try, I just am shitty at it. And I'm sure somebody out there will say, oh, it's just me, it's just me, I suck at the game. And you know what, you are probably right, but that means I'm not having any fun with it whatsoever. Let's hope that Neketsu Kuku Dodgeball Boo Soccer will be more up my alley. And I'm sure it will be, because I'm a big fan of the Neketsu series. I'm sure this game will be no different. Especially with cookie power. Hang on. That's dodgeball. This is supposed to be a football game. Why does everybody look like they've been sunbathing in Chernobyl? I've seen lobsters less red. Here we go, here's the football. The Neketsu football series was better known as Nintendo World Cup on the NES over here. Which, from what I recall, was quite a fun, totally unserious game. Let's get rolling. Wow, that frame rate. Whoa. And that's interesting. You only control one character on the team. It doesn't switch. It doesn't change. You are just this one guy. That's quite forward thinking for back in the day. And the football itself actually takes a back burner. It definitely takes a back burner to the rest of the action on the pitch, which is twatting the living hell out of the opposing team. Oh, come on, score. Pass to me. Ow! Kicked in the crackers. What a save by the opposing team there. That's a long ball. He's kicked it from one goal to the other. You're going to need to do more than that to score, buddy. Why are you passing it back there, you fool? Pass it upfield. He shoots. Oh, it's cool. Yeah, Kunio-kun is still around. I love Kunio-kun. And I'm really excited to see what they do with the new River City Ransom for 3DS. I've been checking out the trailer. It looks really good. And there's also River City Ransom Underground coming out at some point soon for Steam. and the re-releases are quite often available on lots of different systems. Hey, so it's 0-0. Getting a bit of a pep talk in the back room. Somebody's practicing his Hulk smash. So my strategy is, well, smack the living crap out of the opposition and try and score. That's it. Header in. Oh, so close. See, even with the slower pace of this game and the dodgy frame rate, to me, this is more fun than that human football game that I was playing a second ago. This is way more enjoyable. And it's more forgiving. It's not pacing the living shit out of me for not knowing the controls. This is actually fun just learning how it plays. Or relearning it, because it's been 26 years since this was first released. And I played Nintendo World Cup on the Game Boy, but I've never actually played this PC Engine CD version before. It's a great deal of fun. Visually, it's nothing impressive. Sound-wise, it's nothing to shout home about. But it plays well, and that's all I care about. Give me that freaking ball. Give me the ball. Give me the ball. Ugh. Come on, score! Yes, goal! Yes! We're straight back into the action, no messing about. Can I run it in? No, the AI is too smart for that. Can't just walk the ball in on this game. No, give me the ball. If I can't kick the ball, I'm just gonna kick you, buddy. Yes! We score again. 2-0. It's a war of attrition. It's a battle across that line. Uh-oh. Full time. We win. Okay. Round two. But you know what, I don't think we really need to see a round two. I think we've seen pretty much what the game's all about over the last 8 minutes. It is nice to see the different pitches, and I will play for a moment just to see if it changes the control and the fluidity of the controls. Which it doesn't, it's purely a cosmetic change. Pass. No. Oh, what a save. What a goal. My cheerleaders are not impressed. my striker is never gonna have kids again after that hit. Whoa. Oh, yes! Goal! The equalizer. Ooh! Nearly got that ball in the goal with a super move. Let's try that again, shall we? Right now it's a goal kick, I believe. Corner kick, yeah. Corner kick, sorry. Pass, pass, pass. No! I screwed up the header. That's it, chest it down. Wind up the power attack. Oh, I missed the head! And I think I killed one of the opposition. Do I get points for that? Okay. 15 seconds left on the clock. Oh, so close. Man, that was unlucky. That guy's still laying half dead on the pitch. Can we kill the others? Okay. Hulk smash in the corner is going to win the game for us. Ready? Now, I wonder if their teammate is still dead or not. Let's find out. He's not laying down anymore. He's not resting on his laurels or any other part of his body. I'm sorry, we must destroy you now. I'm taking the ball home. Get it in, get it in, get it in, get it in! Ah, oh, son of a bitch. Yeah, this is... I'm really getting into this. I am really getting into it. I am enjoying this quite a great deal, despite the slow pace and the frame rate and the... well, function over style graphics. This is a fun game. Definitely a fun game. Come on, let's hit old Baldy over there. Let's take him out. Take him out. Yeah, there we go. That's it. Well done, computer. Take him out. No! Get that ball back. Get that ball back. Come on. He shoots. Does he score? Get it in there, Kunio-kun. Just gonna hold on for 14 seconds for the draw. No, give me the ball. So 1-1, we ended a draw. The lady might not be happy with us, but I am happy with this game. Uh-oh. According to this, I have lost connection on my DualShock. And it's back, okay. Never mind. False alarm. But that was, that is Neketsu Kuku Dodgeball Boo Soccer Hen CD. And that will be going into my top list, absolutely. At some position. A position I haven't disclosed or decided yet, but I think it will definitely be in there. So let's move on. We'll do one more game tonight and then I'm going to call it because it is now 2 a.m. and I've got to look after my children in the morning. So we're going to play one more game. Let's make it a good one, huh? Let's make it an interesting one. First off, let's open the floor. Let's say, anyone watching, do you have any suggestions of what game to play next? I am going to swap the camera over to show you my list. And feel free to select one. Just bear with me. I'm just going to add my window capture here. My display capture, should I say. Okay, so this is my display. Let's highlight the games here. So out of this selection, these are the games that I have yet to record. I'll give, say, 30 seconds for somebody to pick one. The first one to be picked is the game I will play to end tonight's stream. And if after 30 seconds, well, I'll just pick one. Okay, so your 30 seconds start from the moment I get that timer on screen. Here comes the timer, any moment now. Excuse me while I just turn that off for a second. Okay, so let me just flick back to the actual games. 30 seconds, and your time starts now. The first one to select a game is the game I'll play. Any suggestions at all? No? Okay, well, time is up, so it will be my selection. I'm going to select something. Okay. So, let me see. Something that we can end on. Something that is going to be quite enjoyable. Something that I like, perhaps. So let's do Monster Lair, Wonder Boy 3. Okay, so here we go, on to Monster Lair. For some reason, my controller has stopped working, perhaps because of that minor disconnect, so I will re-add it. I'm just going to have to restart the program so that it can detect the controller again. Hang tight. This will just take a moment. Okay, we should be back in business now. Let's just configure the controls. No. Right, what's going on here then? Say no controller connected. So, let's unplug and replug. It's picked it up straight away, so... Is the game going to actually work for us now? Button configuration's working. Okay, I just have to reconfigure through the software here. So let me just get that sorted. It will only take a second. In fact, it's already done. Here we go. Monster Lair, ladies and gentlemen. This will be the last game of the evening. It's probably one of the weaker entries into the Wonder Boy series. But I'm still glad to see that Wonder Boy is getting a bit of a resurgence. It was announced yesterday that the original Wonder Boy game is being remastered and remade with HD cartoony visuals for Steam. And that is going to be sweet. Can't wait for that. And also there's a Monster Boy game, which is going to be part of the Wonder Boy series, coming out soon for a console. So yeah, really pumped. Wonder Boy is a series that I loved as a child, including the Adventure Island sub-series for various machines. And it's a shame it never really got to see a 3D version. Shield. Look at that. No, lemon ain't worth it, bruv. Nah, lemon ain't worth it. Leave it. Yeah, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. Leave it, bruv. Let's go in this dragon's mouth. Okay. Ow. That hurt. I'm gonna have to build my health back up. Let's screw those fish. Let's give them a good screwing. Damn, dead. Eat that. Oh shit. My dancing just knocked out the controller. Crap. Oops-a-daisy. I still have access to it though in game, so we're all good. Monkey. Bald-headed monkey. A bit like me, really. You know, even though this is probably the worst Wonder Boy in the series, it's still a bit of fun. I still enjoy playing it. And there is... there is no real way that this PC Engine CD version could be possibly viewed as being better than the Sega Mega Drive version. But the music is worth listening to. The audio's great on it. But visually and gameplay-wise, this is nowhere close to the Sega version. Which was the original, I believe. The Sega version was the original. Come on, I need health. I need health. Give me health. Give me health or it'll give me death. Okay, now we're talking. Okay, now we're getting there again. Full health. Alright, let's roll. And why isn't Wonder Boy actually touching the floor? I'm floating. Ow, 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 ow. I don't like this weapon too much. It encourages you to get up close and personal, and that is just not my style in a shmup game. Especially a platforming shmup game, I like to take them out from a distance. This is more my kind of weapon. Ow. I got beach pulled to death. And now the snake's just gonna screw me over. God damn it. Ah, no. No, I'm not gonna die. Not like this. Come on, at least get me through this. Come on. Do I have to hurt every segment on this snake? I was aiming for the head, but perhaps I have to damage each and every part of it before I can kill it. Yeah, there we go. Okay. I lost a lot of lives in that process, but we made it. We did it. And then I accidentally pressed all the buttons on the controller, and it reset the PC Engine, so I guess we're calling that a night. I'm going to have to sort out the DualShock 4 controller or get the original Xbox controller, the Xbox One controller, working properly. Try and get rid of that stick drift that was causing me problems. So I apologize for the abrupt end to the stream. I wasn't expecting it to just go and just fucking fall over on me, but it was fun. I had fun. PC Engine still has a lot to offer. At this point, we've gone through, after tonight's games, we have gone through a substantial amount. We're over the halfway mark, and we have a further 94 games left to play. I say 94 because even though my system says 95, I've just noticed that the Japanese version of the game that we've just played is exactly the same as the American version, so I kind of kill two birds with one stone on that one. This is the other version of it here. We'll just boot it up for posterity's sake. But as you can see, it's exactly the same game, so there is no point me recording footage twice for the same title. When I delete that one, it leaves us with 94 games left to record and play. So we've done quite well. We've made good headway. We'll continue doing this. However, we won't be doing it on my next stream. The next stream is going to be on Sunday, the 25th of September. And on the 25th of September, we're going to pause the PC Engine stuff because it's my birthday. Yeah, I'm going to be 36 on Sunday, and I would like to celebrate that by going back to my birth year, which was 1980, which was quite a significant year for video games. Not only was I born, which of course makes absolutely zero difference to the video game industry whatsoever, but Pac-Man was born. Rogue was born. You know, you hear the term roguelike. Well, the original Rogue was released in 1980. The Sinclair system, the ZX80, was also released that year, which led on to the ZX81 and subsequently the ZX Spectrum, which kind of single-handedly turned Britain into one of the video game creation powerhouses and birthed the bedroom coder phenomenon of the 80s. So we've got that to cover. We've got Defender was released in 1980. Yeah, so there are quite a few games that astonishingly enough were released that far back that still have kind of a relevance today. I mean, you just do a search for 1980 in video gaming and see what comes up. The first arcade awards based on the video games of the 70s was 1980. Brodabund, Bugbite and Howl Laboratory was set up in 80. Mindscape even. So there's a lot going on. A Missile Command was released. Rally X, the first game with a bonus round, was released in 80. Battle Zone, which is one of my favorite arcade games. The Atari 2600 port of Space Invaders. Zork, a text-based adventure made by Infocom. The Nintendo Game & Watch handheld systems. All of this stuff was released in 1980. So 1980 was pretty significant for video gaming. It was the dawn of the golden age of arcade games. 80 to 84 really was a massive, massive era for video games. Yeah, I just want to highlight a few bits, play a few of these games again, get through a fair whack, maybe some Atari 600, 2600 stuff. There was a lot of that released in 1980 also. And just basically celebrate 1980 as well as me. I don't mean to sound egotistical, but I would just like to end my birthday by seeing my part in the universe and seeing what else happened on that day. And maybe we can diversify into other content that's not video game related, like musicians that were born on my birthday. So let's see, born in 1980. Born on September 25th, 1980. Let's just get a good idea of who was born on the same day as me. So, famous birthdays. Let's just get an idea. Oh shit, this makes me feel depressed. I share a birthday with some very, very famous people, and I ain't one of them. Will Smith. I share a birthday with Will Smith. I also share a birthday with Luke Skywalker himself, Mark Hamill. Scottie Pippen from the Chicago Bulls. Catherine Zeta-Jones, who was a very sexy lady when she was younger. And her husband, Michael Douglas, both share my birthday of September the 25th. Christopher Reeve was born in 1980, at September 25th. Let's see, now I'm just looking for any other names here that I recognize. J.B. Heineman from the Mythbusters. He shares a birthday with me too. So maybe we can go and congratulate them and give them a happy birthday as well. There's also a lot of nobodies, people that I've never heard of. Trent Maxwell. Who knows of him? He's apparently a reality star. Yari Perez, who's age 17, as a musical star. Never heard of her. Ryan Beatty, a pop singer who's 20, born on the same day. There's a Vine star called Hungry Benny, who's a tender age of 14. Holy shit, these old people are all worth way more than I am, sharing the same birthday. What the hell happened? Screw my life. But anyway, I digress. We'll go into that on September 25th, on the birthday. It will probably be nearer midnight, so on the midnight leading into Monday 26th in British time, the evening of the 25th of September American time, we can have a good fun stream, yeah? Let's have a good time. Good times. All right, so as it's now 2:15 in the morning, I'm going to go to bed, and yeah, hopefully I will see you all Sunday. In the meantime, if you want to do me a favor and give me a great birthday present, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on Twitter. We are very close to 4,200 subs on YouTube, and we're currently, when I last checked tonight, at 953,000 views. It would be amazing to get 1 million views at the end of the month. That would be really, really cool. But either way, as long as you support me and as long as you enjoy the content I make, then that's the best thing I can ask for my birthday. If you want to give me a tip, however, if you want to buy me a beer for my birthday, then I have a Patreon account. That's patreon.com/juggernaut. I treat it as a tip jar. You won't get any additional content, but it's there if you just want to support what I do and want to appreciate the hours I spend, you know, making videos like the top 50 lists, which can take 40 to 50 hours each. Things like that. If you want to contribute, and if you feel that way inclined, by all means, please do check out my Patreon account. If you don't wish to, if you don't agree with Patreon, if you don't want to support the channel financially in that respect, then that is absolutely cool. As long as you enjoy my content and you keep watching it, as I say, that's all I really wish from you guys. So thank you very much for your support. I feel really old, hitting 36 very shortly. But I hope that I'll be able to share a part of my birthday with you guys. So until then, take care, and I'll speak to you in a couple of days. Bye for now.